गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर अनीता कुमारी, ट्यूटर पैथोलॉजी, जीएमसी बेतिया। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट जनरल एंड फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ यूरिन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट केमिकल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ यूरिन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोटीन। नॉर्मली किडनीज एक्सक्रीट स्कैंट अमाउंट ऑफ प्रोटीन इन यूरिन अप टू 150 मिलीग्राम पर 24 आवर्स। प्रोटीन्यूरिया रेफर्स टू प्रोटीन एक्सक्रीशन इन यूरिन ग्रेटर दैन 150 मिलीग्राम पर 24 आवर्स इन एडल्ट्स। कॉजेज ऑफ प्रोटीन्यूरिया आर ग्लोमेरुलर प्रोटीन्यूरिया, ट्यूबुलर प्रोटीन्यूरिया, ओवरफ्लो प्रोटीन्यूरिया, हीमोडायनेमिक प्रोटीन्यूरिया एंड पोस्ट रीनल प्रोटीन्यूरिया। ग्लोमेरुलर प्रोटीन्यूरिया, प्रोटीन्यूरिया ड्यू टू इंक्रीज्ड परमेबिलिटी ऑफ ग्लोमेरुलर कैपिलरी वॉल इज कॉल्ड एज ग्लोमेरुलर प्रोटीन्यूरिया। सेलेक्टिव एंड नॉन सेलेक्टिव प्रोटीन्यूरिया कैन बी डिस्टिंग्विश्ड बाय यूरिन प्रोटीन इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस। इन सेलेक्टिव प्रोटीन्यूरिया एल्बुमिन एंड ट्रांसफरिन बैंड्स आर सीन, वाइल इन नॉन सेलेक्टिव टाइप द पैटर्न रिजेंबल्स दैट ऑफ सीरम। ट्यूबुलर प्रोटीन्यूरिया, प्रोटीन्यूरिया कॉज्ड बाय रीनल ट्यूबुलर डिसफंक्शन। कॉजेज ऑफ रीनल ट्यूबुलर प्रोटीन्यूरिया आर acute and chronic pyelonephritis, heavy metal poisoning, tuberculosis of kidney. Overflow proteinuria, when concentration of a low molecular weight protein rises in plasma, it overflows from plasma into the urine. Causes of overflow proteinuria are Bones-Jones protein in cases of plasma cell dyskeriasis, hemoglobin in cases of hemoglobin comes in urine in cases of intravascular hemolysis, myoglobin in cases of skeletal muscle trauma, lysozyme in cases of acute myeloid leukemia type M4 and M5 variant. Hemodynamic proteinuria, alteration of blood flow through the glomeruli causes increased filtration of protein. Causes are high fever, hypertension, congestive cardiac failure and heavy exercise. Post renal proteinuria, this is caused by inflammatory or neoplastic conditions in renal pelvis, ureter, bladder, prostate and urethra. Now tests for detection of protein. Heat and acetic acid test is based on the principle that protein gets precipitated when boiled in an acidic solution. Method, we will take a test tube is filled with 2/3 with urine. The tube is inclined at an angle and the upper portion is boiled over the flame. Convection current generated by heat do not disturb the precipitate and the upper portion can be compared. Cloudiness or turbidity indicates presence of either phosphates or proteins. Turbidity due to phosphate, a few drops of 10% acetic acid are added and upper portion is boiled again. Turbidity due to phosphate disappears while that due to proteins does not. Test for detection of protein by reagent strip method. The reagent area of the strip is coated with an indicator and buffered to an acid pH which changes color in the presence of proteins. The reagent area is impregnated with bromophenol blue indicator buffered to pH 3 with citrate. When the dye gets absorbed to protein, there is change in ionization that leads to change in color of the indicator. The test is a semi-quantitative method. Reagent strip test is mainly reactive to albumin. It is false negative in the presence of Benz-Jones proteins, myoglobin and hemoglobin. False positive can be seen in cases of gross hematuria, highly alkaline urine and contaminated urine. Test for detection of protein by sulfosalicylic acid test. Addition of sulfosalicylic acid to the urine causes formation of a white precipitate if proteins are present. We will take 2 ml of clear urine in a test tube. If reaction of urine is neutral or alkaline, a drop of glacial acetic acid is added. Add 2 to 3 drops of 3 to 5% sulfosalicylic acid. Now we will examine for turbidity against a dark background. This test is more sensitive and reliable than boiling test. False positive test may occur due to gross hematuria, highly concentrated urine, radiographic contrast dye, excess uric acid, tolbutamide, sulfonamide, salicylates and penicillin. False negative occurs when the urine is very dilute. The test can detect albumin, myoglobin, hemoglobin, Benz-Jones proteins also. Now we will discuss about detection of glucose in urine. The main indication for testing for glucose in urine is detection of unsuspected diabetes mellitus or follow-up of known diabetic patients. Normally, a very small amount of glucose is excreted in urine, that is less than 15 mg per dL. Presence of detectable amount of glucose in urine is called as glucosuria or glycosuria. Glycosuria results if the filter glucose load exceeds the capacity of renal tubular reabsorption. Most common cause is hyperglycemia from diabetes mellitus. Now, tests for detection of glucose in urine. Benedict's test. When urine is boiled in Benedict's solution, blue alkaline copper sulfate is reduced to red-brown cuprous oxide if a reducing agent is present. Method. We will take 5 ml of Benedict's reagent in a test tube, add 0.5 ml or 8 drops of urine, mix well. Boil over a flame for 2 minutes. Allow to cool at room temperature. Now note the color changes if there is any. The result is reported in grades as follows. Nil means there is no change from blue color. Trace, green color without precipitate. 1 plus is given when green color appears with precipitate. 2 plus is given when brown precipitate is seen, 3 plus when yellow orange precipitate is seen, and 4 plus when red precipitate is seen. Benedict's test detects all reducing substances like glucose, fructose, and lactose. It is not specific for glucose. Sensitivity for Benedict's test is 200 mg of glucose per dL. Now you can see in the picture, blue solution is seen when there is no glucose in the urine. Green precipitate is when 1 plus, 2 plus in when orange, and 3 plus is when brick red precipitate. Glucose can be detected by reagent strip method also. This test is specific for glucose and is therefore preferred over Benedict's test. It is based on glucose oxidase peroxidase reaction. This test is more sensitive than Benedict's qualitative test and specific only for glucose. Other reducing agents give negative reaction. Sensitivity of the test is about 100 mg glucose per dl of urine. Now we will discuss about causes of glycosuria. Glycosuria with hyperglycemia is seen in cases of diabetes, acromegaly, Cushing's disease, hyperthyroidism, drugs like corticosteroids. Glycosuria without hyperglycemia, it can be seen in renal tubular dysfunction. We will discuss about ketones, bile salts and other substances in next class. Thank you.